Today, we're going to be doing part 4 of the pilot tutorial. I know it's been a while, but that's because I've been making this video. In the past 3 videos, we discussed the controls, the gameplay, and which nation you want to choose. So by now, you should have chosen your nation. For demonstrative purposes, I'm going to be using the USSR as my beginning nation. Today's episode will focus primarily on grinding, because that's what this game is about. You have to grind to unlock the vehicles. So that's why today I've decided to give you the top tips and tricks for grinding in War Thunder so that you will have the best plane. As I've stated earlier, you probably already chose your nation. So what you're gonna want to do is unlock the easiest bomber to get. Okay, so in this instance, this is the easiest bomber to get. It's only 1.7, so I would just use a biplane, an arcade or realistic, whatever, and then I'll get the bomber. Okay, now you have the bomber. Choose crew, put it. Here it is, big and bold. So the quickest speed for getting the research points and the fastest and hardest grind technique happens to be simulator battles. And it may seem a little intimidating at first because you can't even go in third person, but trust me, you will get so much RP so fast that you're gonna forget all about it. So in order to join one, click the game mode, choose sim, and you'll see a room list, boom. Now choose a fudging thing. So I'm gonna go with Corsun here, so take part. Let's go to battle. Okay, you're gonna see all these airfields. So as part of the strategy, you're gonna wanna choose the one that's most near to these blue dots here. I don't know if you can see them. Here, I'll zoom in. See them? They're blue dots. Click the airfield closest to them, so boom. And then choose your loadout. So I'm gonna go with the bombs, the big ones. All right, spawn in. Okay, you're in the cockpit, and there's this weird circle thing that you've never seen before because you're new to the game and you're probably garbage and you suck. That's just your joystick. And trust me, this is way better than any flight stick or controller. This is the best way to play. So never even consider getting VR or freaking joystick or freaking Xbox controller or something like that. This is the way to do it. This mouse wheel thing. So start your engine by pressing I, because it's I for engine, stands for engine. You might struggle a little taking off, but if you just go full throttle, it'll be as stable as can be. Look at that, we're off the ground. Now press G to put up your gear, because it'll rip off if you go too fast. Make sure you don't crash, okay? So the blue dots we were looking at earlier, so head to them. So in simulator mode, the colors are inverted. Blue signifies enemy, red signifies friendly. This rule doesn't apply to airfields, however, so keep that in mind. Your airfield is blue because it's friendly, but the enemy vehicles are blue because it's simulator mode. So while we're flying, might as well go over the basic instrumentation in the cockpit. So that is your heat meter, so that detects how much the solar rays are affecting the skin of your aircraft. The hotter your aircraft is, the softer the skin. Therefore, the higher chance you're gonna rip. As you can see, my plane's at around what it looks like to be 430 degrees. This is in Kelvin, so keep that in mind. It's not Fahrenheit or Celsius. Right under that is the RWR. So as you can see, the dials are pointing that way. That means I'm getting a lot of radar detections from that direction. But this is an early aircraft, so it's probably just the solar rays that were heating up the plane in this dial. That's why they're next to each other, because they can be related. Over here, we have another RWR, because in case that one gets shot. As you can see on the bottom middle right there, that is the tsunami warning system. So if there's a tsunami coming to an airfield, it will start flashing. That means take off as soon as possible before the tsunami hits. Okay, I passed our target by accident, so I gotta turn around. As you can see, it's really easy to turn around. Oh, I forgot to mention, really important for self-defense. If you press V, you can go in the gunner view. And as you can see, if I shoot, then bullets happen. So if you see enemy planes, feel free to open fire. Remember, enemy planes in simulator don't have a name tag. So if they don't have a name tag and they come close and then they have a name tag, that's how you know it's an enemy, because beforehand they didn't have one. Friendlies will have a name tag no matter the distance. So anyway, back to the bombing run. I just flew over them again. So for the last time, I'm gonna spin around. There's a friendly. As you can see, his name tag won't disappear when he gets away from me. That's how you know it's friendly. As you can see, it's not disappearing. So anyway, the targets are very nearby. It's just hard to see them in sim since they're enemy, they don't have name tags. Oh, there they are. They're on the road. So I'm gonna see if I can drop a bomb here. Okay, I dropped both. Hopefully we can get a kill. Got him. Let's go. That's all you need to do. Once you have those two kills down, it only takes one, honestly, but once you do that, slam into the nearest, because you just made a ton of money. You just made an insane amount. So let me just make this forest better. Okay, no profits here because mission is in progress. We gotta wait for it to finish. So I'm gonna wait patiently and I'll record the results. So see you in a bit. Wow, would you look at that? Those are some crazy numbers. With this amount of points, you can skip a few ranks. With this amount of RP in one game, you can skip from this bomber to a late prop or maybe even an early jet. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go and start to use I'll start using an early jet. So the best one to do for Russia would be a MiG-9. And that's what we're gonna do in part 5. I'm gonna be going over jet basics in part 5. So thank you so much for sitting here and watching the quickest and hardest grinding technique, quickest speed for getting a research points. So please like the video and subscribe. When I met you in the summer, to my heartbeat sound, we fell in love as the leaves turn brown. And we could be together, baby, as long as skies are blue. You act so weird.